It's time for Health Futures with Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth. This is Arizona's only show dedicated to providing you with expert advice on how to live a longer, healthier, and happier life. To learn more, call 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Bob Roth.
Good afternoon. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth, and it must be Friday, and indeed it is. We're coming at you live from the Scottsdale Air Park Money Radio Studios, 1510 AM, 105.3 FM, and the World Wide Web, moneyradio1510.com. If this is the first time you're tuning into our show is about how our older adult population can live a healthier, happier life. And how do they do that? They do that by listening right here to Health Futures. This show is not about me. It's about these extraordinary guests that I have on the show. And today is no different. I have in the house, I got Duet Partners in Health and Aging. And this is a social service organization that is near and dear to my heart. I had the opportunity to serve on their board for several terms, and I've been personally supporting their mission and their cause for over 20 years. So welcome to the Health Futures Studio. Duet is here. I've got Ann Wheat, who's the executive director, and she has been on the show before. And I've got George Miller, new to the show, but not new to radio, I understand. He is the volunteer and outreach coordinator for Duet. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Bob.
It's great to be here.
It's great to have you back. And, you know, we can't do what we do without the work that you guys do. I mean, we need these type of supportive services for the older adult population. And there's no better way than to tee up our show than to ask you, Anne, tell us a little bit about Duet so our listeners know a little bit more about the great work that you guys are doing in our community.
Duet Partners in Health and Aging was actually founded in 1981, so 42 years ago, with a vision of a community where every person ages with compassion, dignity, and hope. And we pursue that vision through a mission of providing improving health and well-being for vulnerable older adults through free-of-charge services that help them to remain successful in their lives, engaged, happy, and active in their lives, or help them through some of the challenges that come with the vulnerabilities of aging. Our three core service areas include supporting about 400 homebound adults, wow, neighbors as we call them. That's done through the help of a dedicated group of trained, background-checked volunteers who help them to successfully live in their homes, remain in their homes where they want to be, where their memories are. And the typical neighbor we serve is a 85-year-old woman living alone with multiple chronic health conditions on a fixed income of $1,200 to $1,500 a month. Mm. So the volunteers are the backbone to that service. They provide transportation, grocery shopping, friendly visiting, and things like that. You'll hear more about that. We also support a huge number of kinship families, primarily grandfamilies, grandparents, who take on the difficult work of raising grandchildren whose parents are not able to be parents. Mm. And it's a growing number in Arizona, about 60,000.
Wow.
Yes, we have two social workers who help them with just an array of services, from legal assistance to respite care to workshop series, support groups, and the like. Lots of family activities for those grandfamilies. And then we support a huge number of family caregivers. So these are individuals caring for adults who really face some of the most difficult journeys, Alzheimer's, dementia, Parkinson's, and things like that.
Yeah, the family caregivers, they are really the silent heroes out there. We got about 50 million in our country that are providing services for their loved ones.
We do. They are really the backbone of our healthcare system.
They are.
Without them, we would not be able to really care for people.
And my listeners have heard me talk about family caregivers. You know, they are making the ultimate sacrifice. And, you know, I'll make this appeal probably throughout the show, but if you know of someone that is doing this role, you know, don't ask, just do. Help them, because they don't really necessarily seek out the help. They think they've got it. And you and I know this stat, right? It's an AARP stat that couples caring for one another, 65 and older, without outside assistance from family members, friends, neighbors, or even a professional home care company like Cypress, 63% of the time, the caregiver predeceases the care recipient. It's hard work.
It's very hard work. And unsupported, they're just in isolation. It's not like an instruction manual just lands in your hands when you get a difficult diagnosis or see that your loved one can no longer fully care for themselves. And oftentimes with older adults, it's a progression, a progressive debilitating experience. And so they need that support. They shouldn't have to become the second casualties of the diseases that they are, you know, their loved ones are facing. And with support, they can be successful, but it is a reality that unsupported, they often do, more often than not, I think, according to some studies, predecease the person they're caring for.
Well, there's nobody that really understands what it's like to be a family caregiver than you, my friend. And you've been a family caregiver to both your parents, to a sister, and I believe others too in your life. It's hard work. And plus, you did lead the Family Caregiving Initiative for Duet, right?
I did. Other than serving on the board of directors for 6 years, when I, after retirement, I wanted to get back to some meaningful work that I could be very passionate about. And Duet was the right place for me. So I joined as Director of Family Caregiver Services and did that for about 5 years before becoming Executive Director.
Well, I got to tell you, the three verticals that you just described are really so needed in our community. I mean, we're talking about family caregivers. 60,000 grandparents are raising grandchildren in our state. I know that Duet can't get out to all of them. And I know that we've embraced the whole concept of using Zoom and Google Meets so that we can have these support group initiatives. And, you know, I know that you can maybe share some of those that you are doing to reach out to so many of these grandparents that are raising grandchildren.
I'd be happy to share some of the things.
Please.
We do. Duet always was a one person helping another in person organization, and we learned a lot from the pandemic. We provide all of our services in a virtual format wherever possible, but we also are bringing back the in-person opportunity. So kind of the best of both worlds. I think support groups are the most important wraparound service one can provide to a caregiver, whether that's a grandparent or other kin or a family member caring for a spouse or someone else in their family. And so we do provide in the family caregiver space for support groups, 19 different support groups a month, most of which meet every other week. So more like 38 meetings that are available. And they have quite an array of focuses, which does matter sometimes. We are a landing spot for any family caregiver, but we have specialized groups for caregivers of individuals with Alzheimer's and dementia, Parkinson's. We have an LGBTQ caregiver group, a men's group. We have a support group that's very popular for adult children caring for their parents. So, and now we've started bilingual groups as well.
I love this.
Along with the ones that we run for grandparents raising grandchildren. So it's, I think, one of the most important gifts we kind of bring to the community of caregiving. And we're very proud of that. And if I didn't mention it, all of these services for 42 years continue to be provided free of charge.
You did not present that, but yes, so true. And I love the fact that, you know, some of the support groups are now adult children caring for parents and aging grandparents. I mean, they need to have the tools. And I've said it before on this show. I mean, support groups are so important because so many of the people that are out there, they think they're alone in doing this. And by being with peers of yours that are doing very similar work, opens up the door for you to share and learn and maybe learn better practices and doing your role as that family caregiver better.
It is so true.
Well, as you can hear the music, I want to touch a little bit more on the background and the work that Duet is doing here in our community. And then I really want to punt it over to George and really peel back the onion and learn about what you guys are doing to add volunteers to the program and to the mix. You listen to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth. We're down one segment. We got three more to go. Duet Partners in Health and Aging are in the house. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth. And if you're just tuning in, we're in our second segment here. I've got Duet Partners in Health and Aging here in the studio with me. I've got Ann Wheat, who's the executive director, and I've got George Miller. He's the volunteer and outreach coordinator for Duet. If you missed that first segment, please go up to our website at cypresshomecare.com. Click on the media button. Right below that is radio show. You'll catch this one and many, many more. When we were talking in the first segment, Ann, we were talking really about the origins of Duet and the amazing work that you're doing. And you talked about and you touched on homebound adults. You talked about grandparents raising grandchildren, and you talked about family caregivers. And, you know, and we last left off talking about the support groups and how amazing they are and how we really need to encourage a lot of these folks that are doing family caregiving work, or it's grandparents raising grandchildren, or as I learned, adult children caring for their parents or grandparents, those type of support groups. I'd like to pick up on that.
You know, there is such an array of support services out there for family caregivers. We know that they first have to recognize that they are family caregivers. And Once they do, they're much more apt to reach out for help and support. And now the virtual opportunities are great, which is tremendously important considering the epidemic of isolation and loneliness, particularly the negative impact that continues even past the pandemic for caregivers. And also, of course, homebound adults. I just want to touch on the educational components available. We do run web-based webinars, educational sessions, and have several coming up. We do them for family caregivers. We have them May 17th is one with a local therapist talking about the complexities of caring for someone with a cognitive impairment and the anxiety and depression that can come with that and how to address that. On May 19th, we have a workshop on teens and adolescent brain development for the grand families. And on June 12th, we have a webinar with Dr. Patricio Reyes, a neurologist, chief of neurology at our local VA hospital, on Lewy body dementia, Parkinson's, and frontotemporal, some of the lesser known. And that is geared for family caregivers to give them a better understanding. And then in the world of caring for people who are homebound, as we call them, our neighbors, you know, one of the trends we've really seen is that in the past, I think our average age might have been in the 70s, now it's mid-80s, but out of the nearly 400 homebound adults that we support, 60 of them are 90 and above, and 12 are centenarians. And they're living happily with purpose, and they all to a person really think of their volunteer as their friend. That is the single most important thing to for a person to age gracefully and successfully, is having your, you know, meaningful relationships. And so they get that from these volunteers. It's really an incredible thing on both sides, benefiting not only the homebound person,
but the volunteer.
Yes. And I will just share, and I'm not going to steal George's thunder here, but this one I'm just so proud of. Our longest served adult has been with Duet for 38 years, and our longest serving volunteer has supported her for 35 of those years.
Wow.
And that really, I think, says volumes about how
38
this,
and 35
that's,
years.
That's correct.
They must be thick as thieves. They're like
they
besties.
Are thick as thieves. Yeah. They can answer each other's sentences or, you know, finish their
I
sentences.
Love it.
And it just shows what compassion can do, what a difference that can make in a community, in quality of life for people.
Well, I'm going to give you a plug. I did ask you to do this, but I'm going to give it to you because, you know, you can't do any of this work without fundraising. And you get it through grants, you get it through philanthropy and many other sources, the city and
individual
DHS,
donors.
Individual donors. But your website is dynamite. So duetaz.org, duetaz.org, or call if you're interested in volunteering or if you need services, you can call 602-274-5022. And there's a really big green button at the very, very top right called donate. And we need you to donate. We need assistance to be able to carry out the missions that Duet has set up, and especially in these three verticals that we've talked about.
Thank you for that. And it does take a village. And we do really rely on support from the community to do what we do.
Do you still have the interactive map on your website?
We do.
And it could be a great segue into really getting a chance to talk to George, because that in and of itself, I thought when I first saw it was brilliant, because you can see where the need is and you can drill all the way down. So why don't we punt it over to George and really talk about what you're doing over on the volunteer program, because your outreach and volunteer work is vital to making the mission and carrying out this mission, because without the 400 some odd volunteers you have, Duet doesn't really exist.
Yes, and first I'd like to thank you, Bob, for giving us this platform. This is an amazing platform
thank
to
you.
Share what we're doing. And a little background on myself before I go into this. I was prior military, and then I was a college instructor. And during COVID, the school shut down. And so I dusted off my nursing license, and I went and took care of COVID patients. And the reason why I bring this up is because when I came back from overseas, everybody's thank you for your service. And after our shift taking care of COVID patients, people are outside clapping. And I would like to add to that list volunteers. The volunteers need to be recognized a lot more in the community
for what
they're doing, because they're heroes just as much as anybody else.
Mm-hmm.
And people need respite care. You know, families need a break. And for those of you out there that have taken care of family members, you know, sometimes you just need a couple days off or a couple hours off to get that time to recover and regroup so you can go back and give that best level of care.
Mm-hmm.
And helping others is a win-win. And what I mean by that is what we've discovered in the medical field is we're social beings. And so when we help and we give to another person, it actually helps us physically.
Mm-hmm.
It releases oxytocin, dopamine, serotonin, lowers blood pressure, lowers cortisol, lowers our stress levels. And so there's a lot of reasons why we need to have volunteers giving back. And a lot of times when I talk to the volunteers, they realize that they actually got more from the time that they were helping somebody than the person that they helped. And so it's really critical that we get that word out and we get this next generation coming in to volunteer. Because when I was teaching at the college, I saw a paradigm change in the youngsters. I came up in the 80s, and we talked about this before the show, and the mantra was greed is good. And this generation is like, okay, I have to make a living, but I want to be able to make a difference while I make a living.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is a way you can do that. Just for an hour or two, you know, a week, you can make a major difference in somebody's life. Because we know when people lose their independence, depression sets in relatively
mm-hmm.
quickly.
Oh, absolutely.
And so the longer someone could have independence and autonomy, the better off they are. And so we need those people to come in and just help, even if it's for an hour a week, it makes a major difference in these people's lives. The other thing that when I used to volunteer that I discovered is because I'm a history buff, and so I loved studying history. But when I met a woman that was in a concentration camp and could share the story firsthand, and when I met some of the other people that went through the Depression and other eras, I got to experience it at a different level than I did when I was just reading it in a book.
Oh, absolutely. Now, you know, I want to talk more about the work that you're doing when we come back in the third segment, but I want our listeners to know loneliness, social isolation is running rampant upon our older adult population. This pandemic made things a lot worse. We got one third of our population, 65 and older, living home alone. And the volunteer work is amazing. So I'm at halftime here. Duet's in the house. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth. If you're just tuning in, we're in our second half here, and I have got Duet Partners in Health and Aging here in the studio with me. I've got Ann Wheat, who's the executive director, and I've got George Miller, the volunteer outreach coordinator for Duet. And if you missed our first half, go up to our website at cypresshomecare.com. Click on the media button right below. That is radio show. You'll catch this one and many, many more. In our second segment, we talked a lot about we finished up talking about the work that Duet does, but then we went over to have George talk about the volunteers and how important that is. And, you know, we talked about the support groups, and, you know, I ended the segment really talking about one third of our population, 65 and older, living home alone, and how social isolation is a real issue. You know, I also want to remind people, you know, there's a great quote by our former president's wife, Rosalynn Carter, that said, you know, there are four types of people out there in this world. You know, those that have been caregiver, those that are currently caregiver, those that will be caregivers, and those that will need a caregiver. And, you know, the caregiving work is hard work. No question. Ann talked about that in the first segment, and I revealed to our listeners that she was a caregiver, not only for her mom and dad, but for a sibling of hers. And I was a family caregiver for both my mother and father, and this is really hard work. And the work that Duet does to be a resource to our community, to be a resource for these family caregivers, to be a resource for these grandparents raising grandchildren, to be a resource to these homebound adults that need assistance. You know, babies get touched over 100 times a day. There are people that are homebound right now, aging adults that may not get touched a week, once a week, or once a month. I mean, we as human beings, we crave this interaction. We crave holding hands. We crave a hug. It means so much to us. So we need support. We need Duet. We need volunteers. So, George, I'm going to go back over to you to talk about the volunteer work and the outreach work that you're doing to try to attract more people to this work. And you talked about generationally. You talked about growing up in the 80s and, you know, greed being, you know, the mantra. And now, today, you know, these younger generations are looking for more purpose, and they're looking to do more in their community.
Yes, they definitely are. And we're brainstorming ways that we can help them while they're helping us. And one of the things that we talked about in the last meeting is writing them a letter of recommendation on letterhead. Because for some of them, this would be the first job they ever had. And I used to sit on interview panels, and I know the weight that it carries when you turn in a resume and it shows that you volunteered in the community. That carries a lot of weight in the decision-making process of those corporations.
Absolutely. We talked about the interactive map. I don't know if you want to talk about that now or later in the segment, but you can really see the need And as volunteers, you can take a look and say, wow, that's in my neighborhood, right? We don't want volunteers driving an hour, but a volunteer that could drive 5 or 10 minutes to help somebody maybe go to the grocery store or go to the doctor's office or maybe just companionship.
Exactly. And one of the things I learned when I was in high school, gentleman that I was training under my part-time job, he said, the first time you meet somebody, don't be asking for something. Be offering something.
Mm.
And I have a master's in business, but that carried me a lot more than any lecture I received at the university. And so what I do in the community is I've written books on leadership, communication, team building. I was a corporate trainer for 10 years on managing millennials and now the Z generation. And so I offer free workshops to the community.
I love it.
On leadership and communication. Group as small as four. Prior to COVID, I was talking to groups as large as 3,000 or 4,000. So, and I do that as a service to the community. And then at the end, I'll add the caveat that, you know, I'm with Duet and we're always looking for help. And so it's a win-win. I'm providing a service to them and they're giving me a platform to share what we're doing. And one of the families that stands out that's volunteering, we were talking about, a mother was volunteering and her son's like, I want to be part of this. I want to be able to make an impact in the community as well. And so now we have a mother and son team volunteering time together. Amazing.
I love it. So I want to make an appeal to our listeners about volunteers. What are your requirements to have someone join the team?
Well, we have a orientation and we go over in detail. I don't want to bog us down too much on
no,
the radio.
But is there an age? Is there a background check? You know,
yes.
What are the requirements?
I'll let Anne elaborate a little bit on the background and what that entails.
Yes, they must be an adult. They will.
Is that 18 or 20?
18. I believe 18.
Okay.
And have a pretty high level, background check. Because they're working with folks who are vulnerable. So everyone
Absolutely.
Who is a volunteer working directly with a person who needs their assistance will have that Arizona Level 1 background check.
Nice.
And then, like you mentioned with the map, Duet was the first to develop such a map. And it really is great. You could just go to our website, and if you're interested in volunteering, you can look at that and see who is in your area and what some of the need is. And there is need. Right now we have 116 people waiting. We
wow.
never have had that much until the pandemic and volunteerism dropped off even further. But that really literally is the need right now for volunteers. And we have volunteers who just drive folks to medical appointments or other places, pharmacies and things like that. But then we have those that are matched one-on-one with a homebound neighbor, and those relationships really blossom. So we try to meet the whole array of people and what time availability they have, and it ends up being quite rewarding for everyone.
I love it. I love it. And you meet them where they're at. That's the important thing.
And I'd like to add a caveat to that, because I've talked to several groups already, and I get a lot of people that come up to me and they're like, well, I don't have a social work background or I don't have a medical background. And I said, you know, the most important prerequisite to this is empathy.
Right.
You know, that's not going to come from a textbook. It's not going to come from a classroom. If you have empathy towards your fellow man, trust me, we can find a way to utilize you.
That's a word I use in caregiving. Empathy is so important. Compassion and empathy are what we look for in our caregivers. So same type of person. And this person that you're looking to engage is someone that is giving of their time and really helping a fellow brother or sister out in their journey and trying to keep them engaged rather than isolated is so important.
Yes, yes. And there's a big difference between sympathy and empathy. Sympathy oftentimes you feel sorry for somebody and you're thankful you're not
sure.
them. The word empathy means to literally see through the eyes of another.
Mm.
And so our volunteers are great at that, putting themselves in another person's shoes and being there through that trial or that need with them, right beside them. And I can't thank them enough for what they're doing for us.
I 100%. thank you to the volunteers that really make Duet Duet. So we talked about in the first segment, we talked about support groups, and we talked about, you know, because of the pandemic. I mean, the pandemic changed the world in so many different ways. And I happen to know this with Duet. I mean, Duet didn't stop. Duet kept on going.
We never missed a day. We just had to figure out how to do it differently.
Can you share a little bit on how you did things differently? And then, you know, we may get to it in this segment, but I'd be remiss if I didn't bring up the Meaning and Hope Institute. So please share with us how we didn't miss a beat. And if we get a chance to tee that up for the last segment, that'd be fantastic.
Our team is at Duet is amazing. We have folks now who are quite new because we're growing, but also folks who've been with the organization for 17, 18, 24 years. And to a person, when we suddenly realized we had to do things differently, they were on it. We first all had to go figure out how to work out of our homes, something that had not been a model for Duet before. And then, for instance, we have our director of family caregiver services is, by her background, an instructional designer. So she was able to very quickly and professionally turn our in-person support groups or workshop series, like the Finding Meaning and Hope series, into a virtual format. And we were running that very quickly. We did all our support groups virtually. It was where we started doing our educational programs virtually, and now webinars happen every 2 weeks on average.
You said like 38 of them a month, right?
The support groups, yes.
Yeah.
So that's what we did, and we tried to be good students of what to learn, and we brought the best of the virtual world in with a return of some in-person.
I love it. Absolutely, Joe. You hear a little Marshall Tucker taking us out in the third segment. You know, we got one more segment to go. I want to talk a little bit more about the Meaning and Hope Institute and what you guys are doing there. And certainly, you know, George, I want to give you an opportunity to really, you know, conclude our segment and really talk about volunteers and how important they are and make an appeal to get people to sign up and come aboard. You're listening to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth. We're down three segments, and we got one more to go. We got Duet Partners Health and Aging in the house. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You listen to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth. And if you're just tuning in, we're in our fourth segment here. I've got Duet Partners in Health and Aging here in the studio. I've got Ann Wheat, who's the executive director. I've got George Miller, the volunteer and outreach coordinator. And we have talked about a lot of stuff relating to Duet and the great work that they're doing in our community. If you missed any of it, go up to our website at cypresshomecare.com. Click on the media button. Radio show is right below that. At the end of the third segment, I kind of teed this one up, really talking about, you know, the support groups that Duet is running, but more importantly, this new initiative called the Meaning and Hope Institute. And I think that's really important for our listeners to hear about this and maybe a little bit about Dr. Pauline Voss. And she was just here a couple weeks ago. And what an amazing person. And an amazing person who has given Duet Partners in Health and Aging the manuscript, if you would, to this whole program.
She really has. She's been, I consider her a national treasure for caregivers of loved ones who have dementia. And so about 2016, when I was director of family caregiver services, one of the family caregivers in our Alzheimer's dementia group brought in a book by Dr. Pauline Voss called Loving Someone Who Has Dementia, How to Find Hope While Coping with Stress and Grief. We now see about more than half of our family caregivers who come to support groups are caring for someone with dementia, and that's a pretty standard thing.
Half.
It's more than half.
More
slightly
than half.
More than half.
Wow.
Yes, and here in Arizona, where we have such a high number of seniors or older adults, we also have the highest incidence of diagnosis of Alzheimer's and related dementias. It's a very difficult thing that goes along with the fact that we are at, you know, an elder adult, you know, state.
And you did mention a doctor earlier, Dr. Patricio Reyes. He's kind of like world renowned. I actually came across someone a couple weeks ago and floated his name because they had Alzheimer's. Oh, yeah, we know who he is.
He's a volunteer of Duets and volunteers to do the webinar series and several other things, including serving on our National Advisory Council for the Meaning and Hope Institute, which I need to explain. So once we got the book and used it as a book club model, I had never seen our family caregivers go so deep with something or be so impacted in a positive way. And we decided we were going to try to do something to multiply the impact that Dr. Boss's work could have with dementia family caregivers. So with the help of some funding from Virginia G. Piper Charitable Trust, we were able to bring Dr. Boss to Phoenix with a professional video company to create a workshop series featuring 10 videos of Dr. Boss with real-life family caregivers of persons with dementia in conversation, wow, sharing chapter by chapter about her work in the complex grief she identified and named ambiguous loss. So for these particular caregivers, it comes with caring for someone who's physically present but psychologically absent or missing, and to whom you are slowly becoming a stranger. It takes a great toll. It increases the stress more than any other aspect of caring for someone with dementia, more than the heavy workload and the long hours. And they don't understand it. They don't have a name for it. And as Dr. Boss says, once you have a name for something, you could do something about it. So she, through these videos, she teaches them the resiliency-based strategies to successfully navigate the journey, find meaning in it, and hope for the future. And so we have facilitators who facilitate as volunteers, hour and a half long sessions, 10 of them, and we take caregivers through them as a group. So they have a community. They learn out of isolation and in community, which matters a great deal. The Meaning and Hope Institute was developed through a national grant, and we now have a web platform that is a virtual community of care and support. It offers access to all of our services at the click of a button, and it has now not only been growing across Maricopa County and Arizona, but nationally as well. We have trained facilitators in 12 states. We also have it available for Spanish speakers. We have it voiced over and sub-captioned in Spanish, and bilingual facilitators now leading that in Arizona. And most recently, the first Finding Meaning and Hope series was completed on the Navajo Nation with our new partner, SoSo Foundation. And that will soon, before the end of the year, the whole series will be voiced over in Diné, so that the older adult Diné-speaking family caregivers on the Navajo Nation will all have access to that. It's very exciting to us.
Oh, it is.
And really, we do want to create a national movement and make this available. There's nothing else like it. And with Dr. Boss's support and encouragement, carry that out to caregivers across the country.
You know, not only is Dr. Boss trained and experienced in leading these type of sessions, she personally went through the journey herself. And to hear you talk about this, your own personal journey, I mean, you get it. You get these tools that she has created, this gift that she has given to us to give to these families that are so struggling.
It has been a personal journey for me, and I was 8 years in caring for a sister with the rarest form of dementia along with other family members. It was a really difficult journey for us. I was working as Director of Family Caregiver Services but I had never heard of Dr. Boss's work. And when that caregiver brought it into me and I read that book, for me personally, it was like a tectonic shift.
Wow.
And we see that all the time with caregivers. There's just this, so that's what's going on with me. That's what I'm feeling.
Hmm.
And I think the most critical part of that is that they learn from Dr. Boss that she believes the vast majority of them are not depressed, though if they go to a doctor, they're just diagnosed. And what happens when you're diagnosed with depression? You're put on medication and possibly therapy. But she contends that they have every right to be deeply, chronically sad through these very long journeys.
Hmm.
And that the cure for that is community. It's having the family of your heart and mind, those fellow travelers.
Mm.
It's learning resiliency-based strategies to get you through. And it works. We just have gotten the latest survey summary, comprehensive survey we do pre and post 2022, and it clearly shows statistically significant improvements in lowering caregiver stress, increasing their sense of well-being, and increases in their belief about their health and the health of their loved ones.
Love it.
So
love it. I did want to give a big shout out. You want to learn more about the Meaning and Hope Institute, go to meaningandhope.org. It's right up on the website. You can learn more about it. So we don't have that much time left here in this fourth segment. I'm going to turn it over to you, George, to really make your final appeal, talk about the volunteers and outreach that you want to message out to our community and to our listeners right now.
Okay, I'll definitely do that. I want to add one more thing to that. I used to work with a physician, he was Chinese, and he said, in China, we have a saying. If the only tool that you have is a hammer, you're going to tend to treat everything like a nail. And he said, what we're doing is we're giving these caregivers a lot more tools to have in their toolbox, because everybody at some point is going to hit threshold. So it's really critical that we do that. My phone number is 602-274-5022. Most of the time I'm out of the office, but give them a call. They will get a hold of me right away. I would love to come and visit your organization, offer a free workshop, help out wherever I can to get the word out.
If you know anyone that has in their DNA empathy, compassion, and wants to give, and that can be younger adults, it can be older adults, it can be middle-aged people. Duet, Partners in Health and Aging is a great place to go. One more time, that phone number?
602-274-5022. Please give me a call.
Or go out to duetaz.org. Ann Wheat, George Miller, thank you so much for joining me here on Health Futures. Make it a great day. Have a great weekend. We'll be back next Friday.
There's no place like home. You've been listening to Bob Roth's Health Futures. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call Cypress Home Care Solutions at 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Or visit cypresshomecare.com. Be sure to join Health Futures with Bob Roth every Friday at noon, right here on Money Radio 1510 and 105.3 FM.